Eva. No.
Good morning, my beautiful friends, and welcome to How to Make Plant-Based Milk in the Comfort of Your Own Home. Are doing very well. I am so excited to finally be filming today's video. You guys have been highly requesting it, and I have been very much so wanting to film this. As some of you may know, I have been enjoying making my own plant-based milk from home for quite some time now, and I feel like I've really mastered the art of it. So in today's video, I am going to show you how to make 5 different types of plant-based milk at home so that you can do the same and hopefully start to enjoy it as much as I do. Before we get started, I just want to touch base on a few little things. The first thing is what type of equipment you will need. So one thing that you will need is like a nut milk bag or a reusable produce bag. I personally use reusable produce bags. This is like if I were to take this to the supermarket and put like spinach in it instead of getting it in plastic. That's what this is for, but it also works really well for making plant-based milk. So if you have some of these on hand, I recommend using them. Otherwise, I recommend investing in some for both this and then also for the fact that you can take it to the supermarket and avoid purchasing in plastic. The second thing you are going to need is something to store your milk in. Personally, I just have some 500 ml bottles because I'm going to be showing you how to make things by the 500 ml today. I would recommend investing in either some liter glass jars or liter glass bottles, or just something to store your milk in that you know isn't going to leak when it is in the fridge. And then the last thing that you will need is some kind of blender. I personally use a Vitamix. I've been using a Vitamix for almost 3 years and I highly, highly recommend it. But if you have like a Nutribullet or some kind of blender, any kind of blender really, it should work well. So as I mentioned in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make 5 different types of milk. With these milks, I'm going to talk about making them sweetened versus unsweetened. I'm going to talk about making them flavored versus unflavored. Plant-based milk is something that you can honestly do quite a lot with and create your own kind of flavor. So hopefully this just inspires you and educates you on how you can make it at home really easily. I am going to be making it in 500 ml batches today, just because otherwise I would have way too much milk in my fridge and I don't want it to go to waste. So all the recipes that will be left in the description box below, if you want to make a liter, just simply double it. So yes, the first milk we're going to be making is almond milk. And when you are using nuts, if you're using raw nuts, you want to make sure you soak them beforehand just for at least an hour, but you can leave it overnight if that's easier for you. If you're short on time, you can put boiling water and just soak them for like 10 to 15 minutes and they should be all right. When it comes to sweetening your milk, you can choose to sweeten your milk or choose not to sweeten your milk. Personally, I like to use dates most of the time, but today I'm going to show you how you can use dates, rice malt syrup, or maple syrup, depending on what you have on hand and what you would prefer. If you're just making a milk to put in smoothies and things like that, you might choose to just completely not sweeten it at all. So once again, it's very like up to your interpretation and dependent on what you would like to do. But for now, let's get into the first milk that we are making, and this is just going to be straight up almond milk.
Mills of
almond milk. And something I want to quickly touch on before we get into the next recipe is what to do with the pulp. So you would have noticed that I got all of the milk out of this nut milk bag, but then we were left with this pulp in here, which obviously is essentially just almonds, dates, and salt. With the leftover pulp, you can make things like cookies, like bliss balls, plant-based cheeses. You can make creamy sauces with like almonds and cashews and macadamias and things. So I definitely recommend hanging onto it and making something delicious with it. You can keep it for up to 72 hours in the fridge, but I would recommend using it sooner rather than later. Okay, so as you'll probably be able to tell, these hazelnuts are roasted rather than soaked. And when I am making plant-based milk and I want like a really strong flavor from it, AKA hazelnuts are my favorite, so I want a really strong hazelnut flavor in my milk, that is when I roast them because it tends to bring out the flavor more and you can really, really taste it. So whatever nut you're using, if you are wanting to get like a really strong almond flavor, a really strong macadamia flavor, then I would recommend roasting them for about 10 minutes beforehand and allowing them to cool. So what I'm gonna do here is you'll be able to see there's like a shell on the hazelnuts. I'm just going to take the shells off these and then I am going to get into making some hazelnut milk. And with this hazelnut milk, I'm going to use maple as the sweetener and then I'm gonna also add in some flavor to make it like a chocolatey hazelnut milk. You can add the chocolate flavor to other milks if you would like to. I'm just going to show you how to do it on hazelnut milk today. Some cacao and maple to make it a chocolate flavored milk. Something that I did want to note is that similarly to the pulp that we put in the fridge and store for 72 hours, our fresh plant-based milk is the same. So this will last up to 72 hours or 3 days in the fridge. And something that you will notice with your fresh milk when it is in the fridge is that it will separate. So the natural oils from the nuts and the water will start to separate. That doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with it. You just need to shake it up and blend it all together. And then it will be back to normal. Okay, so next up, we're gonna move on to making cashew milk. And for today's cashew milk, I'm going to make it as an unsweetened version. Once again, this is something that if you're just gonna add it to smoothies and you're already gonna add sweetness in the smoothie and things like that, or if you just want an unsweetened milk, you can easily do so. So yeah, I'm gonna show you how to do that today. And in regards to cashew milk is sort of known as one of the more creamy milks and one of the milks that is more neutral in flavor. So if you are after a creamy, neutral flavored milk, then cashew is definitely the one that I would recommend that you try. Anyway, let's get into it. Let's make some unsweetened cashew milk, okay? Cashew milk. As you can see, it was really, really easy to make, and this is something that you can make with all of the other types of nuts and seeds and things that you can make plant-based milk with. So yeah, if you are after something just like super simple, definitely use this recipe, but like sub in the thing that you would like to use in replacement of cashews if you would like to. But from here, we are actually going to move on to making oat milk. Oat milk is one of my favorite milks to make at home, and honestly the most common milk that I make, and that's because it is the most affordable. You can buy a lot of oats for a pretty small amount of money, and a lot of oats makes a lot of oat milk. So yeah, I definitely recommend, if you are thinking that you want to switch to making plant-based milks at home in terms of like being cost effective and saving money, then oat milk is definitely the way to go. And for today's oat milk, I am going to show you how to sweeten it with rice malt syrup, and then we are also going to do like a sweet chai cinnamony kind of flavor on this milk as well. So yeah, that's gonna be our oat milk for the day. Let's get into it. Before we get into that, I want to note that with all of these recipes, they are so interchangeable. So if you've seen me make, for example, that almond milk that I made at the beginning, but you have macadamias, you can very simply sub the almonds for macadamias and things like that. Yeah, my hope with this video was that I could just cover a whole range of different plant-based milks, and so hopefully it just makes it really, really easy for you to make them at home. But if you do have any questions about anything I've covered in this video, just let me know in the comments below. I'm like so distracted by how cute my necklace looks right now. I mentioned this in my recent video with Ana Luisa, but oh my goodness, I'm just so obsessed with their products at the moment. Okay, alrighty, anyway, let's get into our final milk for the day. This is hemp seed milk, which has a really, really earthy flavor to it. It is really, really easy to make, and I'm going to make it vanilla flavored today. Brings us to the end of today's video. I'm pretty sure that I have covered everything that I know in regards to plant-based milks. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know down in the comments below. And if you do decide to make some plant-based milk from home, make sure to tag me on Instagram. I would love to see you making your plant-based milk. And yeah, that pretty much brings us to the end of today's video, but thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate it. I hope you learned a lot from today's video, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you really soon for another one. Have a beautiful day. Bye.